Okay, I'm unmuted. You can go ahead and unmute. Are you good?
Yes, I'm all good.
Yay, we can hear you too. That is awesome. Hello everyone. Welcome to the stream. Kalina here of Story Retold here with, go ahead and introduce yourself.
Lindsay. Oh yeah, I'm Lindsay, aka Tess, for those of you who used to follow us when we were at her interactive. So, hi
Hello.
guys.
And guess what, Lindsay? I don't know if you saw, but you did see that I got 1,000 subscribers since
Yes,
last
which
time
is
we
so
met,
awesome.
which is
So,
a victory dance for everybody in here. And guess what? I brought you all a slice of cake. I did. It, it's
yay!
it's it's very yummy. Here you go. Here you go.
It
It's
looks delicious.
I mean, it's loaded with buttercream frosting. And the center right there is a four berry jam.
I was wondering what type it was. I was like, I don't know, it looks
It's
too dark for raspberry or something, but.
raspberries, black forest cherry, currants, and something else. It's amazing. It's like more on the tart side, so it
Ooh,
balances out
yum.
the sweetness really well. Mug and chair
Oh my gosh.
forever, yes. All right, let me set this someplace you can see.
Bye-bye. First of us, someone said last week. Oh my
There,
gosh.
there's cake, in case anyone asks. Hello, friends!
Y'all
Look at how
enjoying
many
birthday.
people are here. This is so exciting.
Oh
We've
my
got, oh
gosh.
my goodness, I'm not even caught up. Book lover, WD Macy, Glass Half Full, Gabrielle, Elizabeth, Rose Wise, Jennifer Warpool, Kelly Montgomery, Emily Burkett, Carly J, Chaz versus Jazz, Jeremy Field. Did I say your name already? I don't know. Amy Lucio, Emily, I said Emily Burkett, Nancy Drew walkthroughs, hello, Samantha Bartley, I love my Nancy Drew 147, Yandema 211. I'm not even saying everyone's full names, but it's so exciting to see you guys. Anchory Glove, yes, and Gubin Jetpack, hello, and Jamie Nicole. Wait, you're eating homemade Dutch oven bread and olive oil, yum,
Ooh, that
yum.
sounds delicious.
And Rachel
Sounds.
Lawrence, hello everyone. Okay, we're gonna get into
Hi.
playing.
Yes.
Nancy
We
Drew,
did.
Warnings at Waverly Academy, Part 2.
Woohoo!
Is it gonna find it? It
Okay.
has to think about it for a second here. There we
Yeah.
go. There we go. Okay, let's load up the game. Mug and chair.
Mug and chair. I love it. I forgot that's what we had saved it as.
And we're playing on
I love
Senior
it.
Detective because we played Junior together.
Yeah, we're strong, independent sleuths. We don't need no checklist.
Although I keep my own handwritten checklist around here someplace.
That's probably smart.
Okay, it was here. Someplace. No, that's Ghost of Thornton Hole. There it is. Warnings of Waverly Academy.
Close
Great.
enough.
Notes. Okay, who remembers what we were doing last time? Because I don't remember. Do you remember, Tess? Lizzie?
We just honestly, either way, I think we just got the key and the snack shop.
Oh.
So I think so. If memory serves. Yes, okay, yeah, because I remember we stopped because it was like, oh, I forgot the snack shop is right there. So we had to go do one round and then we got that key. And then I don't know what else we were doing for other people.
I
So.
don't know. Wait, what did my notes say?
Oh, there you go, yeah, since you wrote them down. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Animal Crossing? No. Oh, okay, here we go. I got four things on my task list.
Okay, okay.
Read the website. We
Okay.
needed to get into the website. Okay. We needed to call Megan.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Take pictures
And
of
oh, we're taking pictures.
candidates. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And get the password for the library. Did we get that?
Yes, cause, yeah, because we finished the DNA puzzle
That's
thing
done.
that, yeah. Check.
Can't take pics of candidates. Can't check that off yet.
Those are
Okay.
classic. Honestly, me and my siblings quote that all the time. Just her task list phrases. It's great.
Anyone else in chat do that too?
Yeah.
I think it's because
You
of
know you do.
the Nancy Drew games are what taught me how to take notes. Fun fact, okay, story time. Story time. Way back in the day when we had game walkthrough meetings, this is for me in particular, it was games 24 through 32. We would verbally walk through the game before it was made. So the designer and the design team, really, and the writer, which included the creative director, the writer, and the designer, including the QA lead. So she'd be testing it to make sure it what made sense and worked. all of us would be in there, myself included, because I was in marketing and I was there to back up the brand and saying, hey, Nancy doesn't do that. You can't do that. Fans are not going to like that. So anyway, that was my role. But since I was the one who was not actively working on the game, I got to play test the most verbally.
That's so cool.
And so I was like taking notes. Okay, I walked through the hallway. I saw this, this, and that. And I was like taking like very detailed notes and it was not helping. So I finally did what Nancy did, and this is perfect. I took like task list notes, need to find key for blank. And then I'll check that off once the designer says, okay, you found a key. Oh, great. I should go try and use that over there at that door. So that's how I learned how to take Nancy Drew task list notes.
That's brilliant. Oh my goodness. Because then it's something to check off too. You're not just trying to keep track of everything that you do.
Yep.
I mean, like, yeah.
Yep. But...
wow. Chips. That is so cool, though. Oh my gosh.
Anybody else take handwritten notes in chat? Ooh, another key. I'll take that. I don't know what that key is for, though. This looks like coffee beans.
We've got it, though.
That's maybe juice. It is. Maybe. Yeah, I don't
it
know.
Looks like it either looks like coffee beans or like someone is bouncing a ball off of their stomach. Doesn't it kind of look like that a little bit? Maybe? Maybe just me.
I have no idea. Oh, I can't even look at it up there. Oh, sad.
Well, okay. Maybe it's just neat, but oh well. Yeah.
Ooh. Puzzle 2000. Battle gorillas?
What does that say?
Gorillas?
Griffs?
I don't know.
Battle. I can't read that.
I don't know.
Oh well.
Kuba and Jetpack, like, where am I? Going outside. Oh yeah, we haven't gone outside yet. Erica Hurst totally quotes Nancy Drew all the time. You speak my language.
Yes.
Oh, look, there's a Nancy Drew silhouette right here. Look, 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 look. Can you see?
It's right there. Oh, nice. She's just like poking out. They already knew about her before she arrived. How did they not recognize her through her disguise?
Right.
I don't know.
Where's the lock? I can't even see. It's so dark.
I know. Is it behind the inventory thing?
Maybe I don't need to go in there.
Oh, no, it's on the left. It's on the left. Like right there.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, it's not even locked.
Oh.
Nice.
Well, you were ready, though.
I was ready.
Ready in case you did it. Oh, Nancy Drew walkthroughs, battle gories, like categories or something.
Oh.
I bet that would make a lot of sense. That would make a lot of sense. Because I was like, is that like a creature or something? Like, what's a gory? But yeah, that definitely makes so much more sense.
Yep, thank you. Thank you for that clear up.
Mm-hmm.
A Gooba and Jetpack, one day you'll... write out pretty notes, but for now I do chicken scratch notes. Yeah.
Sometimes that's all you can do, you know, before it moves right along, you know, like if you're timed on anything. So.
Should we go out here? I don't remember anything from last week, you guys.
I know. I don't think we went outside. Maybe we did.
Maybe we did.
Maybe we might have looked at that thing and was like, oh, it's locked. Oh, but now we can maybe unlock it.
Yes.
Yay!
Ooh. This is old school light switches. You can buy these, but they're really expensive to be your light switches. They're just push buttons.
Well, that's kind of cool. I wonder what makes them so expensive.
Vintage. Oh, Nancy Drew walkthroughs. Fun fact, on the same bulletin board with the Nancy Drew silhouette, there's a poster for The Campfire Diaries, which was a rehash due to copyright of The Vampire Diaries, her interactive second game. Yes.
I love that.
Macroeconomics?
Looks like it.
In French cinema.
It's a very specific book, I feel like.
Did I just take it? Science can be fun! It can also not be!
So odds are... oh, okay. The human brain and it's... okay.
Oh, I... did I
America
just...
land up... there we go. I don't think we... Did we take them?
No, we didn't. I guess we're just looking through them, huh?
Okay, fair enough.
So I just finished watching Argo Fump's Everything Wrong with Nancy Drew Warnings at Waverly Academy and filming that, which will release on Wednesday. And I didn't realize how many inconsistencies and continuity issues this game had because I never thought about them before.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that there were any. Although I guess when you're in the middle of playing, you're not looking for those. Yeah.
But, oh, by the way, we might say spoilers, you guys, for this game while we talk.
Oh.
Just heads up. Creepy sound effect.
I know.
Yeah. We don't know what we're doing yet.
We're just poking around. We can change the boiler. No one's gonna mind.
Did we keep a book? No, we didn't. We just looked at it. Okay. Who keeps books in the boiler room? In the basement where it's damp?
Maybe with the boiler, maybe it heats up the room enough so where it's not as damp? No, but then that would still... No, that would not work. Never mind.
Maybe. Oh, does this... Does this open that?
Oh! I think it might.
Yay!
Yay! Now we can take all the spoons and the forks and the knives that are there. We do need those.
I'm missing a menu card here. Mm. These are winners. Oh, hi, bud.
They are winners. They totally are winners. Everyone's in here. Okay. You guys are all winners. Oh my gosh!
Can you say hi?
Hi.
Nope, don't do that. No, I know. You think that game is funny since I reacted so much to it. Can you say hello? Say hi.
Hi. A, B, C, D.
A, B, C, D.
Hey.
A.
A.
B.
B.
C.
C.
D.
D.
E.
E.
F. We're stuck on F. X, Y, Z. Y, Z. Y.
Y, Z.
Good job. We're getting through the alphabet.
That was beautiful! Wow! Oh my gosh, Cassie, you've gotten so big!
You say hello? Say bye-bye?
Bye-bye!
Bye! You did so good! You did so good with that alphabet.
Whoop! Don't get tangled up in mommy's cords.
Oh yeah?
Okay. Nope. Okay. Yeah, that's mommy's. Thank you. Okay. Yeah.
Mommy doesn't need that anymore.
Guessing. Come on, let's go.
Come on, bud. Come on.
Cheers.
Hey. Yeah, careful with the light. Bye.
Me.
No, I'm staying here. I'm doing computer stuff, buddy.
Come on, let's go back upstairs.
Bye-bye. Let's go see you want a baby love? You want baby love?
Mm. Oh, my God. My heart.
Daddy.
Come on.
Go with Daddy.
Come on.
I'll be up in a little while, okay, bud?
Mom will be up in a little while.
Go with Daddy. Are you gonna shake a drink?
Cassie, come on. Let's go shake with Nana.
I'll be right back. Hey. Lindsay, you want to take over for just a few minutes?
Sure. You gotta go have some quality time with Cassie.
You go ahead, start doing what you're doing. I'll be right back.
Okay, cool. All right, well, I guess we are going to... Wow! Hello. I went a little bit too far. Let's reverse the course. Come on. Let's go in the opposite direction. Okay. Just a second. There we go. That's better. Oh my gosh. I haven't seen Cassian in so, so long. That was so sweet. Oh my goodness. I totally feel, I've got a niece who's about his age. She's like 4 or 5 months younger than I think he is. But yeah, when she needs mommy, she needs mommy. So we feel that. That is so sweet though. Oh my gosh. The last time I saw Cassian was when he was maybe like a year, year and a half, something like that. So he was still very, very little. So, oh my gosh, I love this so much. Oh. Right? I love my Nancy Drew. It totally should be illegal to be that cute. His mastery of the alphabet. I love it. Nancy Drew walkthrough, this is the miracle of technology where we can swap turns playing different things. So I've just been wandering around with little Jackalope. Welcome back. Little Jackalope. Wow! Wow. What a throwback. I'm used to calling you that in this kind of setting. Oh my gosh. So
Yeah. Erica, yeah, I've got two boys. I've got two baby boys. That was my first one.
He's gotten so big. I was just saying the last time that I've seen him was when he was like maybe a year, year and a half, something like that. It's been a while.
It has. Yeah, they grow so fast, and like a year in an adult's life is like no big deal. a year mm-hmm. in a kid's life, they dramatically change during that
especially
time.
Especially in that toddler phase. It's crazy. I'm like, stop it. You're supposed to be little forever.
All right, so you're doing Roman numerals here. mm-hmm. Yeah, you learned Roman numerals.
We just got to this. So.
Bravo. Bravo.
Oh, I forgot. Yeah, we looked at this last time. So
did we?
Yeah. Well, did we? I thought we did. Maybe not. Huh. Well, we're going to look at it now. Look at this. So now IVXLCDM, which is 1, 5, 10, 50, 100, 500, and 1,000.
Let me write that down.
Oh, yeah. Good call. Good call. I can never keep track. Like, I know the I know the V, and I know the X, and I keep forgetting which one the next ones are supposed to represent. So this will be good to write down.
D is 500. I can never remember that.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Nancy Drew walkthroughs. And for everyone else who's interesting, this is Microsoft Teams. Microsoft Teams.
Yeah.
Okay, here's the thing. Story time. back when Microsoft Teams was becoming a thing, I was trying to set it up for her interactives in inner office workers. And it does so many different things that's kind of overwhelming and can get really like nitty gritty. You can get down in the depths and the details and stuff. And it can be overwhelming. But once you set it up the way it works best for you and your team, it's great. I use it primarily for my job for chat and also for having a listed location where all of our important links are so that I know where to go there. But also it's really good in meetings because there's no time limit and there you can share the screen. Anyways, where was I going with that story? I made it way too messy for our Her Interactive team and was it Indy? I think Indy had a comment about that and she's like, yeah, about Teams. And I'm like, I know. Uh-oh. I know. we can just forget this section of Teams entirely. It's fine. It's too convoluted. I was trying to be very diligent and detailed, but you know. Anyway, back to the game. Go ahead and continue if you would like.
Okay. It might be faster as far as movement. If you go, but it doesn't matter to me. I'm fine with going whatever, but
I'll go ahead and take over. Oh, no.
My mouse is like, oh, okay. Whoa, night fell. All right. I guess it's nighttime already. Oh my gosh. Oh. Wow.
Oh, wow. I guess we lingered too long. Okay. So, So MM is 2000. D is 500, but with a C after it, that means it's 600. One, because there's 100 after 500, which is 600. X, which is 10, which means, but there's a 50 here, so it means 10 before 50, which is 40, and 1. Yeah. So the answer is 2641.
Okay. I believe you, because I couldn't keep track of that.
Garden.
But that's okay. Oh, nice. We should take these little gnomes. Those are from a different game,
yes. I believe. The Haunting of Castle Malloy.
I knew it. I was like, I know I've seen those before. That's right. That's where those were from.
Although, you guys, it was in a few other games. At least one more. Shout out in the chat if you remember which one it was. And I just quoted it, too.
Really? Oh, gosh.
Oh, Ethan Werfel had a question about our pseudonyms.
Oh!
How's it going?
About, like, the Tess and Jackalton?
Yeah, the reason why we had that. So it started kind of with my era. Someone who started the Amateur Sleuth blog was an intern. And I don't think they even used a name. But once the intern left, the marketing team took over the blog writing. And the first person who wrote that, actually the first two people, there were two people who ran marketing. They created their own pseudonyms. Within the company that was like related to detective or something. Huh. And so when I joined the team they're like, it's tradition to have a pseudonym. And plus if you wanted to protect your actual identity, because way back then with social media, I mean, excuse me, it was like possible for people to find you, and I wasn't sure if I wanted people to find me on social or if I get trolled or anything like that. So I agreed to the pseudonym. I thought, little jackalope, because I'm little. And two, that jackalope is one of my favorite mythical creatures. And it was used in Trail of the Twister, which is where I started. So it just kind of started there. Every intern and every continued marketing person who contributed to the blog were all got to choose a pseudonym. And it just became tradition. That's all.
The Missing Book of Stories by Edgar Allan Poe. Do you by any chance know where it is?
No. No offense, but some of the questions you ask are kind of strange.
Thanks for all the advice. Adios.
It's not that strange. It's just asking for a book.
Yeah.
Fine.
Okay, so we needed... Wait, did we get the password? We got the password, right?
Yes. Yeah. It was the coordinates.
Oh, that's right. Did we type that in? Did we get in? We did get in.
Yeah. But I don't remember what we found. So, so we could always go back in and look. But...
Yeah, that's true. Oh, we're still waiting to take pictures. So we're not going to get anywhere unless we take pictures, right?
Oh, that's true. Yeah, we've got Kareen's and Izzy's, I think.
We have Rachel. We need Leela and Rachel. Is Leela around?
That's a great question. She is. Wow, look at that.
You must be the girl who came all the way from France with just the clothes on her back. Becca something?
Becca Sawyer.
I'm Leela Yadav. Welcome to Waverly.
Thanks.
What happened to your wrist?
What a question, Nancy.
I really freak fall and sprained it. I'm supposed to rest it for at least a week. That's why I'm in here instead of the gym shooting baskets. Playing the games in here keeps my reflexes sharp. People think I'm just saying that, but it's true. In fact, let's play air hockey. Come on! By helping me stay in shape, you'll be helping out your new school. You want to get off on the right foot here, don't ya?
Yeah, but I don't have time right now. I told Rachel Hubbard I'd help her with her web project.
That's too bad.
These people.
Do you think the black cat had anything to do with your wrist?
Well, my falling like that was really weird. I mean, ordinarily, I'm real coordinated. But I think it was just bad luck. Happens to everybody. I mean, look at you, being subjected to Rachel on your very first day.
Yes, you can play through Microsoft Teams, Rachel Lawrence. All you have to do is set up a video meeting. And then share the screen. And then once you are sharing the screen and the person can see it, you also have to make sure that they can hear the audio too. But you can give control to the other person or to any person who's in chat. So you can do a group play with your friends if you wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
Why do you say that?
She's got this bizarre schizoid thing going. She'll say something one day, then deny it the next. Or she'll do something, then claim she didn't. She's actually kind of scary. You'll see. In fact, it wouldn't surprise me if she's the black cat.
Really?
See, Rachel flunked a test a couple weeks ago, which means she can't be valedictorian. So maybe, in some twisted way, she thinks we're to blame and she's using this black cat stuff to freak us all out. Not that it's working. On me, at least. I've won state championships in both soccer and basketball. No way am I gonna let a couple of stupid notes get to me.
Yeah, tell him, Leela.
That's right.
Because you're in the running for valedictorian, I need to get a close-up of you for the school website, if that's okay.
No problem. Fire when ready.
Here we go. Here's the third one. And you've got 2.5 seconds.
Are you and Izzy pretty good friends?
We get along. We're roommates mostly because we're both valedictorian candidates, and that's just the way the room assignments worked out.
So you don't know her that well?
Sure I do. I mean, with Izzy, what you see is what you get. She's smart, she's pretty, she's popular, she's always got a boyfriend. That's Izzy. What more is there to know?
Carly J likes playing air hockey. It's kind of fun in this game, it is.
Any idea what happened to the Book of Poe stories that's missing from the library?
I sure don't have it. Mel, our resident goth girl, she probably does. Oh. That freak's probably working on a way to bring him back from the dead so he can autograph it.
Do you ever hang out with my roommate, Corrine?
Not if I can help it.
Ask Mel for book. I'm gonna write that down.
Why not?
Good call. Good
She's
call.
Just a pain. She tries so hard to fit in that it turns people off. Most people, at least. Mel Corbulus and her are friends. No big surprise. After all, weirdos of a feather flock together.
Weirdos, huh?
I've bugged you enough for now.
That's all right. I'm kind of waiting for my boyfriend to call. He goes to Oxborough. That's the boys' school just down the road. Talking to you helped kill the time. I'll see ya.
Really? Okay. All right, so we need to talk to Mel, and we also need to get her picture.
Yes. Yeah. Silver Tech, to be fair, if she figures out how to bring people back to life, she deserves valedictorian. You're totally right. At that point, yeah, she'd be a medical genius.
Yep. Yep.
Becca the new girl, what's going on?
Do you hang out with Izzy much?
I don't hang out with her at all. I can't stand her. She's so fake and vacuous. It's like talking to a mannequin.
How can she be vacuous and be a valedictorian candidate?
You tell me, and we'll both know.
Are you friends with Lila?
Goomba and Jetpack, you're a proud weirdo?
No, although I used to be. Of course, that was in grade school, before she got caught up in sports. Now all she thinks about is competing and winning and school spirit. Stuff I just find pathetic.
So they used to be friends.
Okay, good to know.
Do you think she's smart?
Extremely. Which, to me, makes her descent into jockdom even sadder.
Do most kids like her?
I'm not a fan, but everyone else? You bet.
How well do you know Rachel?
Not well. We don't hang out.
How come?
We have nothing in common. Plus, there's something about her that's a little off.
I can relate.
Why do you think she flunked that test?
Because she's not that smart. In fact, when it comes to being valedictorian, it's a mystery how she ever made it this far.
I called Megan Vargas.
Yeah? How is she?
Haven't you talked to her?
No. We're not very close.
Any particular reason why?
Wow, Nancy.
We're just not, that's all.
I know.
So pressure. She's really pressuring about these questions. Are you good? Do you like her? Do you hang out with her? Do you know?
Where are you going? Who are you with? When are you going to come back again?
Right.
I need to take a close-up of you for a page on the school website I'm helping put up.
The school wants my picture on its website? Groovy. Blast away.
Well, I mean, if you don't have anything in common with a person, that makes total sense to not hang out. That's a good reason.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, nuts. She blinked. What was that?
Oh, I was wondering if you thought, or if she was going to start talking. I was like, oh, wait, we're almost done.
Pause.
Yeah.
I don't do conversations on that subject, remember? Mm. Especially when it's so obvious that it's Izzy.
Gabrielle, you like Mel in this game? You enjoy how honest she is with Nancy? I agree. She's very honest. I like that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
What makes it so obvious?
Izzy doesn't deserve to be valedictorian, and she knows it. She also knows she'll never get into an Ivy League school unless she's valedictorian. So, she has to eliminate the competition.
Do you by any chance have a library book called The Black Cat and Other Poe Stories?
The one that's missing from the library? Sure don't. I've never been much into Edgar. He's a little over the top, even for me.
Maybe I'll pop in again later.
Door's always open.
The only major issue Cybertech has with this game is the models. Something weird, something about them that is just weird. Yeah, different modeling styles for sure.
Not in a Mel way, though.
I think we needed to get Rachel's picture.
Yeah. How about
book
that?
Lover, yeah,
this door's not locked.
The voice acting is so good, yeah, in this game.
Well, the door's unlocked.
They make it so convincing. Wait, is it locked?
It's not locked, and she's not in there. So I can't even go in.
We gotta snoop through. Oh. Well,
locked. I guess it is. Izzy night. Must be somewhere else.
Yeah. I guess we might have to just change the night time to date. Well, you know what? We could log in some of our pictures here and see if they're any good.
Well, true.
What's the time on it? Can you? Is there a time on this? Wait, it's right here.
Oh, on our phone, yeah.
Okay.
43. Oh. It's not that late.
It's not
she
that
should,
late.
She should. What? I love my answer. You break down the door!
Right?
Yes, that is the way to go.
Break the door down. This is hand carved.
We need
mahogany.
Your phone out, Rachel. I'll break it down myself.
Okay. Oh gosh. Okay. Wait, would the catalog say who's got it checked out?
Oh, probably.
Student life, student handbook. Where do we?
Would it be academics, maybe? Or library page?
Where do we enter?
There's your cat, there it is.
We can do this. It's missing. Uh-oh.
Quel dommage.
Oh, here it is. Okay, academics. Here we go. Valedictorian there. Race. okay. Download. More like upload.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then this one.
It was like download onto the computer.
What else do we have? Ah.
Set. Yeah. Okay. I think we just need Megan, maybe, and Rachel. And then I think we have everyone.
Megan and Rachel. I'm just writing these down. Okie doke. What else did we need to look at?
Nice. I love the sound effect. Aww. Ooh, we can look up Erica Hurst as search for Professor Hotchkiss books and Charlena Purcell books. I wonder if we could find, like, I wonder what they'd list.
I think this works with, because this works with Secrets Can Kill Remastered. If you type in the word fiction, you get all nonfiction and fiction. So
wow.
every book entry that the library has is in this catalog by typing in that number, that word.
Yay!
So,
home economics is fiction? Biology is fiction? What in the world? Oh, I guess, if it's nonfiction, because it's got, okay.
Yeah, no, yeah, it says.
I was like, wait a minute!
It includes fiction and nonfiction because it shows up in the search engine.
Smart.
Anger Control, a self-help guide to calming violent urges. I think this was a book that was in Stay Tuned for Danger.
Was it really?
Yeah. There are some puns in here. I mean, in your own time, you can peruse a lot of books.
I didn't realize they had so many in the catalog here.
Yep. Okay.
Yeah, and Demo, Waverly has a very incomplete website. You're right. They need to get on that. All these valedictorian people in charge of this thing.
But don't mention that to Rachel. She'll put you to work on it. Because she's working on the website.
Yes.
How's it going? I'll catch you later.
You can help.
See ya.
Bye.
Erica Hurst, do I know of a list somewhere of all the books listed in the catalog? No, but if you type in the word fiction, you get all of them. I haven't typed them up myself. But once I work on my own website Wikipedia page, I'll make sure to do that.
Awesome.
Okay, well, now what do we do? Did we call? We need to call Megan again? Again?
Do we? Maybe. We could try. It's still early enough in the game website. Day.
Where is Rachel? Hey, what do you guys say? What should we do? Search Professor Hotchkiss books and Charlena Purcell books. Oh, I'll do that next time. incomplete website. Romance novels appropriate at high school? No. I don't think Charlena Purcell romance novels are appropriate in the high school. That's true.
Maybe depending on the romance novel or something. But I just remember like the answering machine or the hold message from Shadow Ranch. But that one was like so extreme and I loved it. I loved every second of that.
Hello,
on the
Becca
wings
Collier.
Of love.
Hi, okay if I ask you something else?
Sure.
How do you like rooming with Mel?
I don't. We were kind of thrown together because of this valedictorian thing.
You don't like her?
The hair, the makeup, the cello. It's all just a little much. I mean, Waverly is a traditional East Coast all-girls school. If she wants to play the deep, soulful, I'm way more enlightened than you neo-hippie chick or whatever the heck she's supposed to be, fine. It just would have made more sense to do it somewhere else, that's all.
Thanks for talking to me.
Catch you later.
Gossip.
But the cello is awesome, though. I don't see what her beef is about that. Tisk, Megan.
Hey, what's going on?
Aw.
I'll check back with you later.
Hit him hard.
Okay, so I really need to talk to Rachel.
Yeah.
Wait, where's that campfire diaries in here? Oh, it's this thing right here. It's very tiny, and you have to bring it up. It's this, yeah. So small.
That's funny. I definitely never noticed that before. Paper tech. It's not a phase, Mom.
Oh wait, was there another set of stairs on the other side? I think there was. I could have gone up that way. Oh my goodness.
Oh well, that's okay. We wanted to go take a scenic detour or something.
Someone didn't lock their door.
Yeah, let's go in and snoop.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Not sure what to do. Word?
Maybe I'll pop in again later.
Maybe we could talk to Kareen.
Yeah, let's do that.
Kareen, do you have any more gossip for us? We gotta talk to people. Goob and Jetpack, pull the fire alarm.
Yeah. Well, did I do that in the last game?
I think you did. Yeah, because we got demerits for that.
Yeah.
I met Leela. She was in the rec room.
She's usually in the gym, either bouncing, kicking, hitting, or throwing some kind of ball. You name a sport, she's great at it. And competitive? That girl loves to win, and almost always does.
Some really competitive people cheat. Does she?
Probably. I mean, I can't prove it, but come on. A jock up for valedictorian? No way. Something's hinky somewhere. And speaking of hinky, she started wrapping her wrist about a week ago, but is it actually hurt? Debatable.
Could she be the black cat?
Well, she's here on a scholarship, so it's real hard for me to believe she's smart enough to, one, secretly be the black cat, and two, divert suspicion by faking an injury and making herself look like a victim of the black cat. But I have to admit, it is possible.
Yandema, I know. I think Megan sounds a lot like Chantal. I think they're the same actress.
Ah.
Yeah.
That would make sense.
Italian Gamer Joe, welcome to the stream!
Hey! Welcome,
any
welcome.
Idea where that book Sorry. That's missing from the library is?
Why? Are you an Edgar Allan Poe fan?
Actually, yeah, I am.
You and me both. Unfortunately, I don't have a clue who has it.
Any idea why it would be missing?
Somebody must have wanted that book and not wanted anyone to know they wanted it. That's all I can figure.
Oh my gosh, that's a thing, what? Italian Gamer Joe? What? That's a thing?
That's so nice of you.
I have no idea how that works, honestly. Thank you. Shout out That's to Italian great. Gamer Joe, you guys. If you haven't, check out his channel, especially on Twitch. He streams some Nancy Drew games. Also, shout out to him because he also co-hosts, or is it co-host? Or is it occasional participation in some of the episodes for a podcast called The Real Housewives of River Heights? Which I laugh every time I say that because it's hilarious.
Did it go missing goodness. Before or after notes from the black cat started showing up?
Before. Right before, in fact. I see what you're getting at. It was called the black cat, wasn't it? That's kind of freaky.
Coincidence.
Ooh. Do you know where I can get the key that opens the special collections cabinet in the library?
You can get it from me. How bad do you want it?
kind of bad. There's a book in the collection I'd really like to look at.
Okay, I just wanted to tease out a part from Arglefump's video here about everything wrong with Warnings at Waverly Academy. This part right here, I agree with, this issue. Nancy pretty much sets herself up to be blackmailed. Nancy could have totally said something like, no, I'm not really a fan, I'm just casually looking for it. But she's like, how bad do you want it? I'm going to make you work for it. Oh, you want it bad? I'll make you really work for it.
Maybe she's like doing that on purpose to allay suspicion, because it's like if she looks all innocent, like, well, I really do want it, then maybe people don't suspect that she's got another angle. It's like playing the psychology games or something. I don't know.
Yep. Well, okay. Do you say, okay, Lindsay, I don't remember if you said you were homeschooled or went to public school or private school or anything like that. I've been to all three. But was it in your school days, were other students, this, I mean, if it includes your siblings, that counts too. were other students like this manipulative or devious or just as, what's the right word, you guys in chat? Brutal. I don't know what the word is I'm looking for, but Nancy mentions it to Ned in this game. Did you experience that at all with other students?
I didn't personally, because I was just like, I go to school to learn stuff, turn in my assignments, and go home. So I wasn't really like I didn't, I was not competitive in any way, shape, or form like that. And I was just like, I'm just here to do my work and go home. So I didn't see any of that. I'm sure there probably was, maybe, but I don't know. I feel like I've heard that more in the context of like smaller private schools or something, but I don't know. So I don't really know anyone that I remember that has that sort of issue with their fellow students. So I don't know. Did you encounter any of that?
Oh, it was like that for sure in public school. Yeah.
Really?
In the schools that I went to, yes. And actually there were some, even in some of the private schools that were nearby, even within their circles, there were cliques and stereotypes that you would kind of fit yourself into. And I don't think I really fit into any of the stereotypes. Okay, guys, chat, for all of you guys in chat, for those of you who have been through junior high and or high school, what, I hate doing this. I need to word this correctly. What type of stereotype did you best fit under? Were you the quiet one? Were you the class clown? I was the quiet, invisible one, because I hated drawing attention to myself. I wasn't the A student, so no one looked at me to be the super smart kid, but I was also, I was more like a B student, so you were like B for boring. Like, of course you're not failing, but you're also not acing either, and I was not fashion forward at all. It was awful. I was so bad.
I find that hard to believe. I mean, like, I know that by the time you meet people later on in the work world, it's different. But I never have gotten that vibe from you. Maybe the quiet thing, but yeah, I definitely, no, I thought you were fashion forward. So I don't know.
That's saying a lot. Thank you. I'm still not as fashion forward as I could be. I buy clothes and then someone says, like, you look like you're wearing my grandma's clothes. And I'm like, darn it.
You look incredible.
I'm missing my warnings at Waverly Academy sweatshirt because it's not here yet. It got delayed in New Jersey.
Oh no.
Anyways.
Okay, here's the deal. I'll give you the cabinet if you can finish these orthographic views for me.
How do I do that?
Just figure out which views go with which object. Each object has a front, top, and side view. Those are examples in case you need them.
I can do that.
Bring them back when you're done. Anything okay. else?
I've bugged you enough. See ya.
Enjoy.
Okay, one moment. I'm going to zoom in on the strategy guide real quick so I have it handy. Oops, let's move this over here. I'm going to hand the game over to Lindsay here.
All right.
To solve. Now you go ahead and take over and I'm going to eat cake.
All right. Okay, here we go. So this is going to be a top view. So we're trying to fit the pieces that match these best, I guess.
Anyway, Italian gamer, this is also for you. Have a slice of cake.
That sounds like the beginning of an advertisement. Have a slice of cake. What? Life is like a cake or something. I don't know. Okay, let's see. This one would be... oh, no, wait. Wait, no, I did this wrong. This would be the front, this would be the side, and this would be the top. There we go. That's better. Okay, I think that looks right. Okay, now we've got this guy, this would be the side, and this would be front, and this would be the top.
Hey, we are in, we're in good company. Just about everybody in the chat. We're quiet kids.
Yeah!
Yeah, quiet kids!
Yay to the quiet kids. Oh, man.
Samantha Bartley, I was homeschooled for about 4 years as well. Chaz versus Jazz was a band geek. Quiet and too nice, glass half full. I was nice too. Like, who else was it? It was, was it Samantha? Samantha, you were the one that people always asked for help with.
Get to this.
You know, the strategy guide is in the way of my.
Oh, of your.
Yeah, I'm gonna
at the bottom. Right front there. Is wrong. That be.
Do do do. I'm gonna catch up on chat here.
Oh, good call. Okay, wait. Then would I switch it here? Does she say when she's all done? Like, I can't remember if this is one where she does that. For.
Actually, oh no. I don't need the audio for this. I think. Hey, does anybody know? Is this a master amateur sleuth puzzle, or is this just one puzzle? I think it's just one puzzle because there's only one answer in the strategy guide. I'm hoping that applies to both levels. Your top left shape is incorrect.
It. Wait, my top left? Like this? Mm-hmm. Top
yeah,
left?
That one.
Oh, the okay.
Front wait. For it is incorrect.
Okay, let's see this.
Sorry,
front.
Which ones were you working on? I wasn't paying attention.
It's okay. I was. Okay. This one. Oh.
Yeah.
Silly me. Okay. Okay. That makes more sense.
Institute okay. walkthroughs and Erica Hurst says this is just one puzzle, so that's great.
Okay. I think this is the side. I think this is correct. Unless everyone is this correct. Looks like it is.
Gooba and Jetpack. Gooba and Jetpack says a flashback to the old streaming days where LJ would make Tess do puzzles she didn't want to do.
That is so true. That is so true. These are great. I love these puzzles. Am I good at these puzzles? That's a different story, but they are fun to do. Okay, wait. Bottom left needs to swap front and side. Okay, so like this. Okay, I think that's right. We should turn it in. Hey, Kareem.
Oh, wait, sorry. I wasn't paying attention. You want me to take a look at it and see if it's right? Well, you can just ask her, though, too. But yeah, we can open it up.
You finished those ortho views for me?
Oh, okay.
I think so.
Okay, let's see what we've got. Sorry.
Oh,
you
no!
You need to check the front view of this one. Anything which, else?
She doesn't even tell you which one!
I'll let you get back to your paper.
Later.
Jazz
someone
versus...
Someone handing you a closed book and be like, oh, yeah, this page just needs to... All right, let's do this again.
Thank you, Gabrielle, as well. And Jennifer Warpool.
Thank you, guys.
Chaz versus Jazz says the bottom left needs to swap front and side. So front and side need to be flipped. Yeah.
There we go. All right.
Italian Gamer Joe says, Tess is a professional now.
You know it.
You finished those ortho views for me?
I should totally be an engineer.
I think so.
Okay, let's see what we've got. Front view's wrong.
Oh, no.
Try again. Anything else?
No.
Erica says the bottom
right
front
is wrong.
Bye. Is wrong.
Later.
Bottom right front. Okay.
I can also look at the guide, which is right in front of me. I'm like, squirrel. Squirrel.
There's so much to look at. There's the chat, there's the game, there's the orthographic views. Okay, wait, front.
Okay, the top right shape.
Yeah.
Flip the side with front.
Oh, have I been just, oh, is and this side the front?
Yes.
Oh,
same
okay,
with the one well, in the bottom right, the shape in the bottom right. Number four, front and side should be flipped as well.
That, okay, that makes more sense. I think that part has always confused me.
Yes, it's not clear which side is supposed to be front. So the shape number three, mm-hmm. also flip front and side.
Okay, so then.
Yep, there you go, try that one.
Okay. I feel like I've switched that one three times. I'm like, I don't know anymore. Italian Gamer Joe, what qualifications do you have for this job? 33 Nancy Games. You're hired.
it wasn't quite like that for me when I joined her interactive, but it was like, which Nancy Drew games have you played? Do you know Photoshop? You're hired. That's what that was what it was for me.
You finished those ortho views for me?
Oh,
there you
yay!
Go.
Okay.
Looks great. Thanks. Here's the key to the cabinet. Whatever books you take out, be sure to put them back when you're done. They're too old and fragile to carry around.
I will.
And leave the key in the lock. I'll grab it later.
I don't think I will.
Anything else?
I'd better get going. Bye.
Suit yourself.
Awesome. Well done, Tess. I mean, it was a team effort with everyone in the chat, too. Though.
Yes. Thank you, guys.
Chaz versus Jazz was screaming at us.
My bad. Thank you, guys. All right. Do you want to take the wheel?
That, I'll take the wheel.
Woo!
What was that key Lena for?
It was for a cabinet.
Oh, okay.
I think it was for the book one in the library.
Special collections or whatever?
Yeah.
Carly J, I can hear Arglefum saying, this puzzle. Quotable.
Seriously.
So quotable.
Mm-hmm. This puzzle.
The Story of Four by Madeline Moore.
Ooh.
Rita Hollowell. Yeah. Look at that picture! Her interactive team members. Okay, fun fact, and you'll see this a little bit better in the end credits. This was designer Robert. She wasn't an intern, but she was the daughter of her. This is Anne. She was production manager. And this is her daughter. She came in every summer to help do some extra work here and there. So that was cool. And then this is designer Kathy. And this is artist Chris Ulmer. And I don't know if she actually had a cat or not that she actually posed with, or if it was photoshopped in. But this photo was taken outside the old office. Do you remember the old office, Lindsay?
Yes. Oh, yeah. On the corner?
Yeah, the patio, the side of the... the side of the parking lot. So the building was right behind it, and this was photoshopped out. She's supposed to be touching one of the big potted vases that was back there.
And so that's what that's really smart. I love the pose. It's so like majestically looking off in the distance kind of thing. I love it. It's very dramatic and I love it.
I don't know if I should share some more behind the scenes information with copyright related things. I think it should be fine. Don't get me into trouble, you guys, okay?
Yes.
I'm not going to name names, but these costumes were rented from a costume shop nearby. And when they used this in the game, the costume shop came back saying, hey, you weren't supposed to, we didn't like that you used these costumes in something that you made for profit. These were rented costumes. You're making money off of our product. And it's actually somewhere buried in copyright law that any imagery that is, what was it? I don't remember the exact term, so don't quote me on this. But if it's a costume and not an actual designer's piece of work, if it's an actual costume, then you can get away with it's copyright free.
Oh.
Her interactive was not in trouble. But to make amends with them, because it was already done, the game was already published. To make amends, Her interactive gave them some extra marketing advertising on the Her interactive website, promoting the costume shop or their online store. So they gave them a little bit of love that way.
That's really great. That's because it could have, Like, I know for other, companies or whatever, it could easily be like, oh, well, what's done is done, bye. But that's great that they did that. So.
Yeah, Italian Gamer Joe, the amount of heart in these games, absolutely. Everyone, mm-hmm. I mean, these team members did not have to do that, dress up like this in these uncomfortable clothes. But
they look fashionably fly.
They look so fashionably fly. Angie Zoe says she's a he or she is a lawyer, and it's fine.
Oh, okay.
Thank you for backing that up. Yes. Okay.
Now,
why did we need to look at that? Oh, it's because we looked at Mel's poster.
Oh, yeah. But now we know that there's a story of four in the library.
Yeah.
That people can read.
How's it going?
Oh, but does that
I
mean...
have harassed
oh,
okay, you yeah. enough.
Sorry.
Pop
go ahead.
In any time.
Does that mean like we can... Are we going to use the photo for anything yet? Or is that later?
That Maybe. Might be later. Did we? I'm not paying attention, you guys. What am I supposed to be doing?
We have another. Did we take another photo? Can we upload that? Or did we not? Did we already do that?
We're missing Rachel and Megan. Why don't we have it? Who's got Megan's picture?
Oh, we didn't. Oh, that's right. We didn't take pictures of the. I think we have to ask someone for her picture, but I can't remember who.
Did we contact everyone that we could, except for Bess and Ned, of course?
Oh yeah, we should talk to them. Be like, hey, here's what's going on. And then otherwise, maybe we could go to bed.
That's a great idea. Let's all go to bed.
Hi, Nancy. You making progress?
Yeah. That's so boring.
Good night.
I've met all the valedictorian candidates.
Cool. Tell me about them.
All right.
Corrine, the girl I'm rooming with, she's not exactly Miss Popularity.
What makes you say that?
So far, I've only met one girl who even halfway likes her.
That's not good.
At this school? It's a disaster.
Keep going. Who else?
Oh, we're just gossiping and gossiping? Oh, okay.
This girl named Rachel asked me to help her with a school project.
How'd you get out of that?
I didn't. I told her I'd help her. And actually, it's a good thing. Gives me an excuse to go poking around, talking to people.
So what's this Rachel person like?
Well, no one around here seems to like her very much.
How come? Bad breath? B.O.? Poor taste in shoes?
She's just strange somehow. Kind of absent-minded. She scares some kids, and she seems to keep to herself.
The quiet loner type, huh? Better keep an eye on her. Keep going. Who else?
Yeah, we're all quiet loner types. Oh, I have I have to say everything here? I can't just leave? Ned? Bye, Ned. Hang up. You want to hang up? No, I can't.
Believe it or not, there's a goth living in the room next to mine.
A goth? As in weird hair and disturbing body piercings? At an exclusive East Coast all-girl boarding school?
She's a legacy, meaning the women in her family have been attending Waverly for generations. If you're a legacy, you're automatically accepted. You're not automatically liked, however.
She doesn't have a lot of friends?
Doesn't seem to.
Is she into black cats?
Don't know that yet.
Maybe I'm a sucker for obvious suspects, but it sounds to me like you should find out. Keep going. Who else?
Jazz versus Jazz. Rachel wrote BS has BO on the bathroom wall as a diversion tactic. From her own BO?
Yes.
Like, this will get everyone off my back.
Somebody walked out of here smelling terrible. It was not me. It must have been Becca.
Spread the word.
Lila Yadev is Waverly's star athlete. And man, is she competitive. Spends most of her time in the rec room trying to get people to play games with her.
She's a valedictorian?
Yep.
No.
Shouldn't she be studying, like...
That was also a thing. Oh, great. Now I'm just going to have Argle Funk's video stuck in my head. No, she is not a valedictorian. She's a candidate for valedictorian. And Zybertech, I fully support that theory that Nancy is a vampire.
Anyone else?
Says she's got everything under control.
A smart jock. Good for her. Keep going. Who else?
Izzy Romero is a valedictorian candidate and student body president.
Is she nice?
She is to me, so far. But that's probably because I'm still new to the pecking order.
She's at the front of it?
Oh, yeah. She rules the roost around here, that's for sure. But she's not without enemies.
Roost rulers seldom are.
I need to get back.
Stay out of trouble.
I'll try, but you know me. Bye.
It's too late, Ned. I already pulled the fire alarm.
I know. We've already got demerits. Right. All bets are off now. Throw caution to the wind.
Hey, what's going on?
Is it true you're here on a scholarship?
That's right. Athletic. Full ride. Although I have to maintain a pretty high grade point average in order to keep it. Luckily for me, that's not a problem.
What would happen if you got injured and couldn't play sports for the rest of the year?
They'd probably pull my scholarship. So not only would I not be valedictorian, I wouldn't even be able to graduate, which would really shoot holes in my future. So if I get injured again and I find out it's this black cat person's fault, believe me, she's going to wind up injured too.
Erica, you can't say things like that, Leela.
Yeah, so mean. Erica Hurst, at one point you tried creating your own Nancy Drew mystery in real life with your cousins. You put magnifying glasses highlighted in red around the house with clues. I want to come.
That's so cool. I know.
Come solve your mystery. That's awesome.
You should make kits or something and sell them at party stores.
Well, actually, I've already started brainstorming
really?
party printout mysteries kits. the Nancy Drew style, where it involves actual puzzles and clues, and all you have to do as the party host is put them in designated rooms, and it's just a scavenger hunt to find those clues and then solve the puzzles that you're presented with. And it includes also a story and stuff, but I haven't started working on it. It's all in my notebook, so that's as far as we've gotten.
That's so cool, though! Oh my gosh, if you... Oh, that would be really cool.
Ooh, Italian Gamer Joe! You did the same thing. You created PowerPoint games called Detective Joe. They're on your YouTube channel, heavily inspired by Nancy Drew. Oh, I'm checking that out tomorrow!
Absolutely! That is so cool!
I'm gonna add to my task list. Go to Italian Gamer Joe's YouTube.
Honestly, PowerPoint is the best. I love using PowerPoint.
PowerPoint.
But to do mystery stuff like that, that's so cool.
Creative.
Yeah.
Would it be okay if you weren't the valedictorian?
It'd be okay with the school, but it sure wouldn't be okay with me. No matter what I'm competing in, I always play to win. The nice thing is, I usually do.
That's it for now.
Hang in there.
Becca Sawyer, I did write a blog post about the mystery of Magnolia Gardens. It's on my website. I needed to add a button to my picture. I'm holding the box up like this. So look for that button and then, or that picture, and you can take a look at that. I really enjoyed it. It was very family friendly and tame compared to the Nancy Drew games. And there was a lot of reading. I thought it was a lot of fun, and it was something I could pick up for 5 minutes, put down, and come back to. I didn't do it all in one sitting, and you can do it by yourself. You could do it with friends and family. It's good. How come we can't ask her for the picture from Megan? What do we do? I'm stuck.
I wonder if we have to like switch to a new day or something.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised, because I feel like we've talked to everyone. And we've like clicked all the things. Yeah, can we go outside maybe?
In the dark.
In the dark.
We can try.
It was a dark and stormy night.
Oh, you sent me the link. Great. Embarrassingly funny. Hey, I'm all for it. I'm all for embarrassing funny. Makes things fun.
This cornerstone looks different than it did in that book.
Okay.
You wanna do it? You wanna do it?
Let's do it. Let's go ahead. Okay. All right, here we go.
Cheering for Tess.
I love it. This is the only dance that I ever want, is the cheer for Tess dance.
Oh, Angie Zoe, I don't know how to pronounce your name. How do you pronounce it? Can you spell it out phonetically for me so I remember? I need to write down everyone's pronunciations for their names, because I ask and then I forget because I'm terrible. It's like, I recognize your face, I recognize your name, I can't put the two together. I thought I talked to Megan all the way, Kelly Montgomery. I thought I did. Maybe I'm supposed to have looked at something first or said something to someone else before talking. I feel like I need to talk to Rachel, though. Carly J says, come on, Tess, this is easy. Ha!
I know, like...
Anyways, and just so my review is the reason you grabbed that Hunt a Killer box. Awesome! And it was like, after I posted that video, I think it was closer to Black Friday, they had it on sale, too. I actually bought two more after I bought myself one. I bought two more. They're in the pile of presents back here. You can kind of see them. I'm gonna give them to some of my friends. Liv Dunstan, you sound familiar. I think I remember you from the Twitch days. How are you, friend? And Mariah, you're here too. Welcome back, friend. Mariah's very excited to see you, Tess.
Oh, thank you. Sorry, I'm like...
She's focused.
I can't figure out... I remember, okay, wait, I don't know about you guys, I have a really intense focus face when I'm like really focused.
Yeah.
And I remember, Calina, one time, what was it, I don't remember what I was even working on, but your husband came in to like take you out to eat or something.
Yeah.
and he saw me like making this intense face, and he like stopped in the kitchen. He's like, the wild Lindsay is in her natural habitat working on her thing. I was like, oh my gosh. I didn't realize it looked that. It was really funny.
Oh my goodness. I have to get something real quick right here because it's for another story. You go ahead and focus.
All right. Okay. I think we're going in a good direction. Now I just need to do. All right. Hey. Too far. This is. Ah. Okay. There we go. Thank you. Yay. Okay. We got this. Like. Every motion is like it overextends, it overcorrects. Woo!
Yay!
Well, hey, little guy.
Oh,
what's
snap.
Up? What are you That's doing? Right. Hey! Come back here!
Nah.
He well, must you have some kind of now. Nest up there.
Oh boy. That's a. I don't like that puzzle. The tree puzzle.
That was the memory one or whatever.
Oh my goodness, I'm getting like so many messages right now.
You're slow, babe.
Tess, I was gonna ask you, do you remember this?
Was that full of candy?
Yes.
Yes. Oh my goodness.
Story time.
I totally forgot about that.
Story time, you guys. This, well, it, what's important right now is that it, I mean, there's no candy in it right now. It's I've got arts and crafts hiding inside. This was bought with one specific purpose. And it's because I kept getting into trouble for bringing in snacks and chocolates and goodies just to have in the kitchen. A particular person, and I will not name names, I don't want to say chewed me out, but gave me a teasing hard time about, you shouldn't be bringing in chocolates. I can't resist every time chocolates are in, and I should not be eating chocolate. I'm like,
which, to be fair, you always brought like a bunch of really good chocolate. Like, it was either the candy that everyone liked or really good quality chocolate or something. So, yeah, in hindsight, I feel that. I feel that deeply. But I remember that. That was really funny.
Yeah. So what I did is I told everybody but that person, okay, here's where the chocolate is. The good stuff will always be hiding in this little box. The combination is 517 because it's not working. But that was also hidden inside of a chef's togue wrapped up in a cupboard behind some kitchen gear. So anytime
you forget about that. It was about all the layers that were involved,
yes,
in hiding.
It was
all
just
of this.
Packed in there. And you know, every once in a while when that person wasn't around or looking, I would go in there and you know, get a piece of chocolate. Goodness. Anyways, where were we? We've got just a few minutes left, and I should wrap it up here soon because the little Cassian wanted me to come upstairs and stuff. So, okay, I'll take over, and we'll finish. Let's get through this one scene, though, that's coming up here.
All right, go for it.
Oh, everything about the bird.
Good to know.
This is old and important. Rita Hallowell.
I can do nothing more.
Wait. That's all we get out of here. Oh, excuse me.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Oh, it's all good.
I'm just drinking tea.
That tea will get you.
It's too dark in here. I can't see a thing.
Oh, goodness. I don't know what to do. I like how the shadow here, every time you turn around, it changes. Like, there's a cat shadow right here behind on the wall.
Oh my gosh!
Is it here that it changes, or is it every time you enter the room? I think it's every time you enter the room.
Whoa! I never noticed that shadow before. Well, that's really cool. See, every time I play these games with you, you always reveal something. It's like, oh my gosh! I never saw that before! Like, I'm playing it for the first time.
Oh boy. Wait. Hang on, I gotta get the guide out. I can never remember which ones are which. Oop. Where is the squirrel puzzle? There it is, okay.
I can't reach. If I want to go after that squirrel, I'm going to have to find another way to get up into this tree.
You remember, Mariah. No, every time I drink soda, I get the hiccups.
Oh, that's right. Oh my goodness. Yeah. Wasn't there like a time we did like root beer floats and it was like less hiccups or something, but still hiccups?
I still got the hiccups, yep.
It's dark and I've never climbed this thing before. Talk about your recipes for disaster.
Book lover, has anyone seen an albino squirrel in real life? I have not.
Ooh, that's a good question. Oh, I have not.
Goodness, Gooba and Jetpack. Awesome.
Oh my goodness.
Wow, thank you. You guys
so nice of you.
Should check out Gooba and Jetpack. They also play Nancy Drew games and they're a lot of fun.
You gotta run. Well, it was great. Thank you for stopping by.
Thank you for stopping by, Gooba and Jetpack. It's always good to see you. Even though I stream at really weird hours sometimes.
Wow!
Oh, we're actually doing it.
Okay. Well, I didn't realize that
since
if we went out now.
I don't know where I'm going. Climbing this tree is probably not a good idea.
Oh, I'm not supposed to do it right now? Where is the
squirrel? Oh, that's right. Okay. I think everyone has to be asleep.
We're going to have to wait until I hear scratching. Okay, well, now might be a good time to call it a day. And I will get caught up and make sure I know what I'm supposed to be doing next time. I'll come a little bit more prepared. I've only got one thing on my task list, and that's actually two. Take pictures of candidates and go to Italian Gamer Joe's YouTube PowerPoint video. Ooh. Yes. Thank you guys for joining.
Yes. Thank you guys. It was so good to see all of you guys again.
Yes, good seeing y'all. I'm just catching up on chat here. According to the WAC microsite, Quigley Kim used to climb this tree to look at bugs. That's funny.
That's really funny.
Mariah Mullins, do we still have your Nancy Drew memes? Her interactive might. I don't think I do. Were they shared on Twitch?
Me.
Absolutely. All right, thanks you guys for joining. We will see you guys next week. Yay. Lindsay, are you good for next week? If something comes
up, absolutely,
you can let me know.
Okay. No, it should be all good. So,
woo. Awesome! I'm so excited. We'll make better progress. I got so many, just so distracted with all the side stories. We'll try to make better progress next time, you guys.
But they're fun. They're fun. It's good.
It's part of the stories. All right. We'll have a good night, all, and enjoy. Yeah. I know someone else had some cake, so. You enjoy that, but enjoy some cake someplace, you guys. Treat yourself. We're all celebrating here because we're having a party. So, good night.
Yeah. Good night.
Bye. Bye.